Hello everybody, it's always a pleasure to be with you in this September 4th for this 5th Katia Jewel Talk. So today it will not should not last too long. I will introduce to you four new capabilities from various applications and role of both 3D Experience Katia and Katia V5. I hope you will enjoy it. Hopefully we'll have time at the end of this presentation I will have time to try to answer your questions. Anyway, remember that if you want to review this presentation, you can access it in the Katia community. So let's share my screen. Hope you see the screen. And for now, what you see on the screen is a 3D Experience Katia. And it's a special application called Katia Die Face Design. By the way, this 3D Experience Katia app is also available in Katia V5 since Katia V5-6 released 2018. So it's brand new. It has a lot of capabilities for sure addressing the die face design need, but it has also very nice capability for, let's say, some other task. So if you see here, this is a car inner wood panel, sheet metal panel, and I will show you how with 3D Experience Katia die face design you can easily fill all those holes, which are of course functional holes from a body in white point of view, but for a die face designer it can be a plastic injection mold as well, or for a plastic injection molding designer doing this, for example, core or cavity side of the mold, it's also mandatory to fill those holes. Okay, so you have this all or fill surface capability. You click on the surface you would like to be filled. And as you can see, he automatically, not completely, but he automatically fills some of the holes. We can have an idea of what it did. And you see that in fact, for some of the holes, it was just, for example, the light blue, the cyan one hole here, it was just did an end trim, which is the highest quality way of filling the hole. We just untrim the hole and we recover the original surface. So this is really the perfect solution. Okay, so he made 30 untrims in this particular case, but he cannot do an untrim here on those two surfaces because it's independent surfaces, even if they are joined. So he cannot do an untrim. So what he did here in this case, it was also a particular case because it was flat. He made a planar fill, okay? In some other area, like the yellow one, it's not so obvious, but it's not at all planar, but he could make a piecewise fill. So he make multiple steps that he connect together. And in some other area, which are a little bit more complex, you can see here, this one, there are a lot of difference. We could probably use the Katia surface fill capability that you may be aware of, but there are some strict criteria here in this command to let the user in control of the quality of the surface he's designing. I'm sure that if I go to surface fill, I click the surface fill, it will fill it. But here, as you can see, there are some depths difference between the various vertices of the pocket, let's say, or of the hole, and Katia does not want to make a bad quality fill, so he will let the user in this case to control what he's doing and check the quality. Okay, it's exactly what I will do. So in fact, he found there are, you can see here, 12 empty holes. You can navigate to all those holes one after the other. Okay, or you can say here, I would like, for example, to fill. There are some message here, but that doesn't matter. So here I'm in control of what I'm doing. I will also fill this guy. I will fill this guy. You see, just one click, but at least I control what I am doing. These are symmetrical holes, so I could have used a mirror capability, but I think it's more fast to do just a quick fill on the hole. Oops. Here we go. I don't have to miss some holes like here, this one. But prior to that, what I can also do is more and say, okay, there are some complex holes. Can you try not to manually fill or let the user manually fill it, but fill all automatically from Qtia? And in this case, in fact, he could not fill all the holes except two small holes here. It's not obvious to see where he made a piecewise fill, of course, in the symmetrical part as well. And now, of course, I can also continue my job because he does not want to create a bad quality surface at the end. And here, very quickly, I was able to fill all the holes of my surface in a very different situation with the most efficient way to fill those particular use cases. I can also look at the quality. So I have multiple quality tool, quality checking tool. One is very well known by the Qtia user, both in V5 and 3D experience, which is a Connect Checker. And the Connect Checker will check the quality of the closure, okay? And looks like it's perfect because it's everywhere zero. So I have not only something which is perfectly watertight from a connectivity and geometrical point of view, but also I optimize the quality of my filling. Now I can say apply. Before I say apply, you can see here there is a default option which is turned on. It will join automatically all those surface filling to the original surface. So I say okay. And here my result, okay? So it's very good quality. It's very fast. In 1 minute, even less, I could, because in my case, I was explaining how to use the command, but you can do the job. If now I take another part, not very similar, again, this capability is available in Qtia Diphase Design in V5. It is available in Qtia Diphase Design 3D Experience Qtia. It's also available in 3D Experience Qtia Core Cavity Separation, which is a tool or the app dedicated to create plastic injection mold and inside the mold designer role. If now I take another part, let's go for this inner door. Here I will not explain to you what I'm doing, just I will run the command. Here we go. I will say more, fill complex hole. Okay. You see, he filled almost everything. The only hole he was not able to fill, but it makes sense, is the window area. Because if you look at this boundary, it's very, very complex corner here. Even more complex in some other area like here. Let me show you. Not easy, okay. So for this, I will use, you know, manual construction, create maybe some intermediate curves and fill piece per step by step this area, okay? So you saw here a very, very nice and very, very high productivity command inside Qtia to do this whole filling. Now let's move to another typical task of diphase designer or plastic injection mold designer, and which is extrapolation. You probably are using extrapolation in Qtia, both V5 or 3D experience, but we have drastically improved and in fact customized the extrapolation for people doing molds, plastic injection mold or stamping die face. Let's go here. This is a typical outer bonnet, like the English are saying, or hood, like the US people are saying. And the idea is that from this bonnet to extrapolate the edge of this bonnet, because we will create later on an addenda surface on top of it. Okay, we have here a particular command, a new command, which is the new extrapolation. So you click on the surface you would like to extrapolate. You click the edges you would like to extrapolate. You can see here these edges. And now let's say usually what I'm starting to do is I say I would like to do a tangency extrapolation, in my case, 70 millimeters. I will explain to you later what I'm doing for the parameter. I apply, and this is a typical tangency extrapolation. So G1 for the mathematician guys. I'm not a mathematician, I'm a user. So tangency extrapolation, but For this particular job, both in plastic injection mold or stamping die face, tangency is not enough. What the people really like is, in fact, to extrapolate in curvature, maybe 5, 6, 10 millimeters, and then create a tangent extrapolation. Okay, it's exactly what this command can do, and it's what I will do here. So I say I would like a 10 millimeters extrapolation in curvature, and then just a 60 millimeters extrapolation in tangency. Apply. It's not an easy task. As you can see, the result is quite different, okay? The result is quite different because the curvature constraint is quite strong, okay? And by the way, as it is quite strong, you can see here that the spanning, the number of span and the position of the span is not that good, okay? Which is normal because this extrapolation of curvature is quite strong, quite complex. Not a problem for Cutia. What we are doing here, very simple. We take the boundary of the curvature extrapolated surface, and we can move, we can step back this boundary. This is this parameter here, step back. Let's put 5 millimeters. Let's imagine, in fact, what I'm doing, I take the boundary of the G2 or curvature extrapolated surface. I make a parallel curve inside the extrapolated surface by 5 millimeters. But then the trick is that I'm smoothing this new boundary, and I will project the smoothed boundary onto the surface and create again my extrapolation. You can see very nice result, very nice quality, and very few patch, a patch distribution which is very good, which is acceptable, and which will not create a further problem when you are, for example, creating the addenda surfaces and create complex fillets. So this is a very nice command of Cutia. And for example, if I want just to finish the job, I will use a similar command on this lateral edge. So this is my surface. This is my edge. I will use the exact same parameter to be consistent, of course. And I say apply. Looks good to me. It succeeded. Okay. And here now, a nice capability, another nice capability of this app, which is a very, very nice jewel of Cutia, is that I can automatically fill this concave area. What I have to do is just pick on the vertices. And as you can see, it automatically filled. And by the way, because my extrapolation was, of course, not exactly matching, it automatically took into account this curve to create the surface. Here is the job. If you have to do the same with the classical tools available in generative shape design, trust me, it takes much, much, much more time. Even if the result will be okay, it takes much, much more time. And of course, this is a feature. It's a feature in Cutia. If now the wood is replaced by another wood, it will be automatically updated according to the parameters I use for this particular design. So we looked here quickly to two nice capability, all filling, but also surface extrapolation. Now I change completely of a topic, and I go to the 3D world of 3D printing. So let's imagine, okay, this is a classically, traditionally designed part. You can see a lot of holes, there are some pockets, there are some go-through pockets, you have some branches. And the idea is, okay, I would like to 3D print, probably in metal, this particular bracket. If you can print it, there is no problem. You will have to optimize the position according to the printing direction, and so on and so on. But prior to that, what you have to know is that when you 3D print, 3D printing does not like sharp edge, okay? It's not good for the process, it's not good for the quality, it's not good for the heat transfer, for the for many, many reasons, you should avoid sharp edge. Now the idea is, okay, how can I avoid sharp edge on this very, very complex part? By the way, there are a lot of sharp edge, okay? Not a problem for Cutia. I go to part design, Here we go. And if you have V5, you need an add-on called Casting and Forging Optimizer. It's an add-on on top of Part Design. It's a very good tool, by the way. You should have it. But if you are in 3D Experience Cotia, we embed this command for every Part Design user. So it's also a very, very good. It's also a very good incentive to move from V5 to 3D Experience Cotia. So in this case, I will use a fillet command, but not a special fillet. I will use auto fillet. This is my current solid. I would like, in fact, to round all the edges by 1 millimeter fillet. Not 31, it will be probably too big, but 1 millimeter. Okay. Now Cotia is looking for all sharp edges and will compute automatically a 1 millimeter radius fillet in all sharp edges. This is not a video, it's real time. I cross my fingers. Here we go. Small message, but it's not a big issue. Here, you see. Maybe I will change the color of the fillet for you to better have a look at how it looks like. Properties, graphic, put it in red. I'm fine with that. You see the job? You see what it did? If you have to do that manually, again, you can do it, Cotia can do it, but it will take you a lot of time. And it has no added value for a designer. It's not functional fillet. It's just a sharp edge that we have to round prior to print it in a powder bed, for example, metal printing machine. Okay, so again, this is in Cotia Part Design in all the mechanical role in 3D Experience Cotia. It's an add-on in V5, which is also containing a lot of other commands like wall thickness analysis, complex filleting, complex draft, but have a look at it. And to finish, because I am a little bit late, I take too much time, something maybe you are not aware of, it's in Imagine and Shape, our subdivision surface dedicated app. And I will show you very simple stuff. Maybe you say, oh, it's not useful, but, and then I will show you a use case in a video, okay? So I have here a subdivision surface. And in fact, I would like to disturb, to let's say, transform this flat subdivision surface by using a picture. Let's have a look at the picture. The picture is this one. It's like a QR code, okay? So let's go back to Cotia. So I go to my Imagine and Shape app. It's both, this command is both available in Cotia V5 and 3D Experience Cotia, by the way. And it's called here, creation of detail modeling. So I click my surface, I select my picture. So this is a QR code picture. And this is, in fact, he use the black and white color to make some pocketing and bosses according to this picture. You can modify the position, you can stretch, you can rotate, you can do whatever. Let's make it simple. I say yes. And here is the result, okay? It's not a mesh, it's not a set of triangle. It's a subdivision surface which has been detailed. And you can export it as a step file. You can imagine that, for example, this is not a QR code, but it can be a black and white silhouette of multiple parts you have to put in a package. And then you will be able to thermoform this housing, this packaging, or maybe do a used cardboard and also forming. And then you can put your various device inside this special packaging, okay? You can do for sure different things. If I double click on this guy, I can maybe change my image. I will not use a QR code, but something I call wave. You will understand why. The result will be very, very strange. You will understand why it is strange. Because you can also play with the height of or the magnitude of the detailing, okay? Takes a little bit more time because the pattern is a little bit more complex, okay? Here, I will just here change the magnitude. The magnitude or the amplitude was 10. I will just put 1 because it's not a packaging or whatever that I want to do. I want to do like a pattern, a 3D pattern. And you can see here, the result is much better. Let's change. Oops. And it's more something, oops, sorry for that. Here we go. I just put it locally. You can see you can perturbate the surface. It's not, it's not a mesh. It's really a subdivision surface. It's an exact C2 continuous surface. This nice capability of CATIA. And now let's see this capability in action on a real industrial case. This is my case. You can see it's a razor. And the idea is to make a packaging, a plastic transparent packaging of the razor, because people would like to see the razor when they are in the shop. And let's see how we can use this exact same capability to make this packaging. So I have my razor. It has been designed with CATIA. This is just a live rendering. And then I will ask to make a depth picture, okay, in CATIA live rendering. It's not in V5. This capability is not in V5. This is the depth. As you can see on the right side, maybe the depth is not really perfect because this area is lower than the two branches that you see in the middle here. So what I will do, I will just use Photoshop, take my depth picture, redraw some area because I want it to be bigger, okay, than just the exact shape. Change the color, put it probably gray. And to have a nice transition, I will use the blurring command of Photoshop to add some Gaussian blur to this area to make it a smooth transition. This is it. I save my picture. And then I will use this particular picture on a subdivision surface. And I'm working now to position the exact modified and detailed imaging and shape subdivision surface to put it at the right location versus the product itself. Once I'm fine, I will just change the property and add a material to the outer shape, put, of course, a transparent white material, because it's mainly plastic, transparent plastic. And then I can use live rendering to show the result. And you see that how very, very quickly I can make a package around a complex product just by using a picture. And in a couple of minutes, this video just lasts 2 minutes. So that's it for me. I think you. I hope you enjoy this this capability. Let me change that. Remove. And hope you enjoy. Hope you understood some new capability of CATIA. Remember, in 3D Experience CATIA, but also in CATIA V5. Hope to get you on board for the 6th. CATIA Dual Talk, which will come in a couple of weeks, with a very, very, very nice new capability of CATIA, on three experience, sorry for that, which is generative tolerancing. How you can generate 3D tolerances, 3D dimensioning on a 3D part, magically. Thanks for your attention. And if you have question, let me check. Okay, I am looking at... what workbench are you using to prepare for 3D printing? We have in fact, this command that I show you for the filleting is in part design. If you are in V5, you need the add-on CATIA casting and forging optimizer. But typically when I am working to prepare a part for 3D printing, I'm using the function-driven generative design app or role, which has a lot of capability for 3D printing. And then in our Delmia suite of portfolio in 3D Experience Total, in Delmia, there is some dedicated application for both powder bed fabrication or even WAM, wire arc additive manufacturing. The software is, I told you, some of the stuff I showed you are in V5, most of them. Some of them are only in 3D Experience, and the one which is only in 3D Experience is in fact the live rendering that I showed you at the very end. What kind of fillets will it do at corners? It's just a regular fillet. So it's just making fillet. It's not a fill. Remember, it's a constant radius everywhere, okay, on all the edge. So it's just a regular fillet, constant. the true power of Katia Fitting, no other CAD. No, I agree for, you know, when I started 35 years ago CAD/CAM, the most complex things to do in CAD/CAM was filleting, offsetting, and draft. 35 years after, the most complex things to do in CAD is filleting, draft, and offset. So it seems same problem, but we are improving. We can apply what I showed you, this detail on the subdivision surface on a non-flat surface, any surface, but it has to be a subdivision surface because in fact it's a special mathematical property of subdivision surface where you can detail locally a subdivision surface. It's mathematically done, so it's not again a polygonal, it's not mesh, whatever. So I hope I answer almost all your questions. New tools added in V6. I need 1 week to talk about what is new in Katia 3D Experience versus V5. A lot of stuff in all the workbenches. This is probably, I need hours and hours to do that. Here, I just pick some nice capability. Why? Because I think people are not aware of that. I don't want to show you how you do regular stuff. So I think I'm fine with that. Maybe we can close the session here. And again, it's always a big, big, big pleasure to be with you. And hopefully you enjoy, like I enjoy being with you and introducing this capability of Katia and sharing information. Bye-bye, have a nice day, evening, night, morning.